So guys, welcome back to Drill's Point. We are discussing about UI controls. So this video would be all about the radio button. Like, what is radio button? What does radio button composed of? Why do we even need a radio button? Do you remember that whenever you are downloading a software, it asks you, do you agree to the terms and conditions? So at that point, you either agree or you disagree. There is no other way, right? So when we have to take a decision from the user to ask something, at that point in time, we use a radio button. So this is a radio button which is having only one option. Either you choose or you say no. It's quite similar to a checkbox, but the difference is that if there are two buttons, then out of those two, only one can be true. So that would be the part of the second session in which we would be going through radio group. But now let's look at the attributes for the radio button. So these can be the attributes for the radio button. The first one being the text, what the text you want to show in the radio button. Then is a checked. By checked, I mean that is the radio button checked or not. It can be true or false. And then is the ID. By ID, I mean that what is the unique ID for the radio button on base of what I would be actually using my activity file or in my Java file. I can use this ID and get the button or it's straight then and there. So now let's see how do we actually get a radio button. To get a radio button, you need to open up your Android Studio, create an application in it, and open up your activity_main file. In this file, in this XML file, you have to take a new radio button. Now, in this button, after this button has been taken up, you go to your main activity.java file or your Java file, and there you can check the state of the button and also work on the button. So, after this, let's see how actually we would be taking all these steps one by one. So here's my radio button. This is the by default property, like its ID. We are having a text in it and the by default state that is checked. We can do it for the other buttons also, right? Now let's see what I have in my this one. So this is my radio button. I make the object of the radio button like this. Here what I'm doing is I am finding the finding view of the button, of whichever button is selected. This would be a bit complicated for you. What you can simply do is, like whatever button you are taken, like if I take an RB1, then you can use this ID and take up the radio button full, and then you can find view by ID. And pass the button that you want. Say I want this is the ID of my XML button. Now after I'm done with this one, I simply check RB1 dot is checked. It will be giving me a boolean saying it's either true or false. I can use this value and say that yes, this button is true. So like if I say that, do you like Java? So if you selected yes, then it would say that yes, this is true, means the user likes Java. So this can be done. And if we are having a radio group, what do we do is, if you're having a radio group, we find that which button is selected out of all the button present in the group. We find that ID and pass it over here. This would be coming up as a part of the radio group when we do it. Currently, we will be doing the coding part of the demo using this particular functionality wherein we would be making a button, fetching the ID, and then checking that is the button checked. So now let's quickly go to our Android Studio and see how to actually work on the radio button. So hello guys, welcome again. As we have already discussed about the radio button, so in this video or in this tutorial, we would be quickly going through a radio button and seeing what are the properties of radio button, how can we take a radio button, where do we use a radio button, and how do we check that if the radio button is checked or unchecked. So let's open up our activity_main.xml, which is present in the layout folder. Here, let's come to the design view and see what design we are having as of now. I'm asking the user agree to two terms and conditions. If he says accept and it's a new button which says that whatever the result, if it's true, then it shows a toast saying true, or else it would be showing a toast saying no. So let's see the property of the radio button actually. This is my radio button. It is having the width as wrap content. We have fixed height. The text is also shown to the user. The name is radio button. We have given the gravity as well. By default, the state that we have given is checked and true, right? We can do it false as well. Is checked is the state which we use to check or to find that if the radio button is clicked or not. So after this, we go to our mainactivity.java file. And here what we have done is we have taken a radio button, we have given it as name as R button, and a button to which should be showing a result. So we took up the button, made it its object using R radio button, and in the button.display we've set an on click listener. We have made the object of the radio button, and using the R.id.radio button, which is a radio button that is present in the XML, type casted it to a radio button in Java, and now would be using in our entire application or in our entire Java file. Now the isChecked is a function which would be returning a boolean telling that if the state is true, false, so which means if it's false, it means it's unchecked. So we are getting this in a boolean variable named as R, and we are doing a toast to make text saying that that's R.toString, which means that it would be shown as a toString to the user. And we are displaying a toast to for a short duration of time. So nothing much in this one, just a small tutorial. So let's run this and check how it behaves on our application. Generally, we use radio buttons when we have to give a choice to the user that it's either true or false, or like when we are asking a gender in the registration form, or when we are asking that do you agree with the terms and conditions and such things. So let me open up my phone over here and show you the result. So if I click this, it's currently false, it's unchecked. If I click this and I check, it's true, which means it is checked. Generally, we won't be able to do with single radio button. We have two radio buttons because it's obviously a choice method. So for that, we are having radio group. We will be discussing radio group in the next session, in which I will be taking you through defining a radio group and how do you actually choose a button and how do you find its ID in a radio group. So that will be covered in the next video. So stay tuned as we bring the radio group for you. Thank you.